Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, I'm Ishwarya. I hope all of you guys are staying safe, staying home. This video is going to be a cooking video and I have become a little chef, if you will. But jokes aside, I've taken a keen interest in cooking because of the quarantine and I seem to be kind of good at it and I seem to be liking it a lot. So I thought, why not make a video of really quick, really tasty recipes that you can have as breakfast or snack, or in fact whenever you want. I just shot a Q&A video just before this and that should be up by now, so if you guys have not watched that, I'm gonna link it down below. So yeah, we are gonna be cooking today and without any further ado, let's get started. So if you guys can hear people behind or music behind or the TV behind, please don't mind. My parents are in the living room and they are watching TV and I obviously cannot stop that, so yeah, please don't mind. So the first recipe that I'm going to show you guys is oats and banana pancakes. I'm sure you guys would have heard this a lot. They're really famous and I love eating pancakes. I mean, who does not? And pancakes form a really good breakfast. First thing that I'm going to show you is oats and banana pancakes. Let's get started. Hi guys, I just wanted to like drop in and say one thing. This is my first cooking video, so if anything is hodgepodge or if anything's not visible or if I'm doing a mistake in cooking, please don't mind. Please, mujhe maaf kar dena. Please. This is my first cooking video. I hope you enjoy. Bye. So for this recipe, all you need is oats. I'm using the Quaker oats. Really ripe banana. The more riper it is, the more better. Half a cup of milk. One or two eggs. A little bit of cinnamon powder and honey to top it up, and if you like you can also add sugar, you can add protein powder. I was going to add protein powder but then I decided not to because I just wanted a plain, not a chocolatey pancake. But if you want a chocolatey pancake, you can add cocoa powder, you can add chocolate protein powder. So yeah, let's get started. I've put in one cup of oats in my blender, the Quaker oats. Then I'm gonna add in the banana. The more ripe it is, the more better. I'm gonna add in one egg. Make this eggless, you don't have to add the egg, it tastes perfectly fine even without the egg. I'm gonna add in half a cup of milk, a little bit of cinnamon powder. I love the taste of cinnamon and bananas. Actually, I love cinnamon and everything, so I'm gonna add in a little bit of cinnamon powder. Also, you can see scotch there. You can add in sugar if you want, but the bananas are very sweet, so I do not want any more sugar. And then we're gonna blend this mixture and make the batter. Also, I forgot to mention, add a little bit of salt in your pancake batter. I forgot to mention that. I put it later, but yeah, don't forget to add salt. The batter is all done, as you guys can see, and now we're gonna fry it and make the pancakes. I'm gonna coat the pan with some non-stick oil. You can use butter, you can use normal oil, you can use coconut oil, you can use whatever that you like. Those are the pancakes ready. I am going to top it up with some bananas because I love eating bananas. Not a lot, just a little bit, and also there's no other fruit right now, or not, I would have used strawberry. Then I'm going to sprinkle some honey. Pancakes are ready. Look how beautiful they look. I love how it's turned out. now that the pancakes are done, we are going to go on to the next recipe, that is besan toast. I'm sure you guys would have had this or seen this sometime, but I really like eating besan toast. They're like the vegetarian version of omelette bread. They're very tasty and I'm really excited to show you. So let's get started. For besan toast, all you need is besan, one chopped onion, one chopped tomato, and some green chilies chopped. Add how much ever you like. I like it to be really spicy, so that. A little bit of haldi and red chili powder and salt. Tomatoes. Red chili powder. The batter is all prepared. I'm going to soak in the bread and fry it. Here is your besan toast. I like eating it with sauce. If you guys like green chutney, you can use green chutney. But there is your besan toast. The next thing that I'm going to make is a banana smoothie curd. It's really easy and really tasty. It's really filling. Banana in general is really filling. So for the banana smoothie, you'll need one banana, which I've already put it in the blender. Half a cup of milk. A little bit of curd and honey for the sweetness. You guys can add sugar if you want. I like the taste of honey. Also, banana is really sweet in itself, so it does not really need sugar. Also, I'm sweating, but yeah. And then blend, and there's your banana smoothie curd ready. That's it. That's your banana smoothie curd ready. This tastes so good and it's so filling, it's so healthy, it does not have sugar, which is the best smoothie ever. And I also like banana milkshakes a lot. Yeah, that's your banana smoothie milkshake. So the last recipe is not a breakfast, but it's a dessert, and it's a really, really yummy dessert. This is something that my best friend and I used to do a long time back when we craved something sweet and we didn't have anything at home. It's really easy, literally just 3 ingredients and that's it. Let's go. Now for this recipe, I've used Mary biscuits. I've used 4 of them and I've crushed it like that in a bowl. I'm gonna add in the superstar of the recipe, which makes the whole recipe, that is Amul fresh cream. I'm gonna add a good dollop of that. Then I've cut up some frozen bananas and I'm just gonna add it. You can add whichever fruit you want and you like. And then I'm just gonna mix this whole thing up. Does not look very appetizing, but it's a really tasty. Try it and then tell me. That's the last recipe. I know it does not look really appetizing, but try it and then tell me. So that brings us to the end of the video. I know you guys must be thinking, why is she using banana in most of her recipes? That's because banana can be easily available right now. You can also add in strawberries, blueberries and whatnot. But I wouldn't suggest you to go finding for them, you know, to a big store. But banana, you can find it at any shop, everywhere. It's so feasible. So I wanted these recipes to be feasible right now because we are in lockdown. So that's the reason I use banana in most of my recipes. So I hope you guys really like this video. I hope you try the recipes out. If you tried, don't forget to tell me in the comments down below. Follow me on my socials. I'm super, super active on my Instagram. Follow me on my Instagram, that is @ishwarya bala. And yeah, I'm gonna catch you in my next video. Until then, bye. Stay safe.